Good morning. My name is Tom Kalinowski. I'm the Director of Technology and Operations at Colonial Intermediate Unit 20. Today is April 3rd, 2019. Welcome to Tech Tips, episode number 59. In today's episode, we're going to go over how you can use Google Docs to print out labels. Let's get started. The first thing you're going to need is your data. So I have a spreadsheet here with a bunch of sample data. You see first name, last name, I have address, city. I'll put a link in the description where you can get this sample data. Next thing we want to do is open up a Google Doc, click on Add-ons, go to Avery Label Merge. If you don't have this, go down to Get Add-ons here and go find Avery Label Merge and add that. Once you do that, click on Avery Label Merge and click on New Merge. Once you do that, you'll get this pop-up here. It'll ask you, do you want address labels or name badges? Let's do address labels in this case. And you pick the particular type that you have. We'll use 5160s in this case. You'll find that number right on the pack of labels that you're using. And go ahead and click on select. The next thing you'll do is click on this spreadsheet that contains your data. In my case, here it is, that US500. That's the name of the file with all of that random data. So we'll go ahead and click on that and click on select. After you click on select, you will be presented with a box on the left-hand side. Your cursor will be blinking in there. If not, go ahead and click in there so the cursor is now blinking. The next thing I want you to do is click on each column header that you want to put in there. So if we're doing address labels, I'll want first name, so we can just click that once. And then I'll hit the space bar to put a space after first name, and then click last name. Okay, we'll hit enter to get to the next one. The next thing we want is address, so we'll click that once. And then we'll click the enter button, and then we'll go city, space, state, space, zip. So now that we have that all set, we can go ahead and specify the rows that we want merged. In my case, I want rows 2 to 501. I don't want row 1 because row 1 is what contains the header, like first name, last name, etc. So it automatically starts at row 2 all the way to the end. If you only wanted to do a subset of your data, you could specify that here. And let's go ahead and click on merge. You'll see the rotating blue graphic here. It's saying merging, please wait. Momentarily, it'll let you know that the document has been completely merged. So we see it created a document, AV5160. Let's go ahead and click on open. What that's doing now is that's opening up the document with all of your merged results. So you can see here that it did merge everything correctly. We have the name, address, city, state, zip. And if we scroll down, we see there's 17 pages of it. When you're ready to print it, you can go ahead and click on print. Make sure when you do print it that you don't enlarge it or decrease it. If you do that, you're going to have a problem with your alignment, with the label, with information actually lining up on the label. So you don't want that. So when you click on print, find the setting on your computer where it says scale, and make sure that scale is set to 100%. And if there's other options for make content fit page, do not click that. We don't want to do any scaling. And then click print, and that's it. So that's a easy way for you to print labels and mail merge information, meaning get information from a spreadsheet and put it on a bunch of labels, really quick and really easy. I hope you found that tip valuable. If you have any questions, certainly put them in the comments below. And if you have any suggestions for future tips, make sure to include that down below as well. Make sure to subscribe to this channel and click on the bell so you can be alerted anytime we post new videos here. I hope you have a good day. Bye.